It's time we give back. Sow a seed and show someone where love's at. Even if you don't give a dime, give your heart and share your time. Help somebody else in life. Give back. Welcome to this episode of Ignite, Empower, Transform. I am your host, Hosea James Givan II, where we showcase urban superheroes here in the Bronx and around the world. Today we have a female entrepreneur that's going to share with us her story, Alease Garrett. Alease, welcome to the show.
Well, thank you for having me.
Absolutely.
I'm excited to be here.
Absolutely. I know you had a little drama getting here.
Oh, yes. New York traffic, of course.
It's crazy on Friday. It's crazy.
Remind me never to do things on Friday here.
Yeah. That's you got to prepare for that.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to open up by getting your early history in terms of how you got into the business world, your interests.
Presently, I'm in the music business, managing several artists and mainly my daughter. That's, you know, she's doing great, you know,
yeah,
up the ladder.
Yeah, I can't wait to see her.
Yes. And how I started, it just, through tragedy, when you lose your parents or you lost, you know, I lost my parents and I was already in the beauty field. I was already working and doing a whole bunch of things related to that. But I sat down one day and she wanted to be an artist since she was 13. And we were doing the Baltimore, you know, little circuit, but I just knew in my business mind, we would never get there if we're not in an entertainment city.
Mm.
So I packed up and moved to Atlanta, but it was through the death of my parents. I said, you know what, how often do you have just money sitting here, decisions to make, do I want to continue? Because I closed my salon when mom, you know, passed away because I had to take care of her.
Mm-hmm.
And then my dad came along. 10 years later, so I had to take care of him.
Right.
But I just said, you know what? I did everything I wanted to do with my career.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go get it.
So at 13, you made a decision to put your energies into developing your daughter's passion.
I packed
and her
up
dream.
My house, sold my cars. At 15, we went to Atlanta, and I was raising a grandson.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Who? That's your older daughter?
Oldest, yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
That's amazing.
Yes.
That's amazing. And to have... You know, I think of my father. My father,
yes.
Still with us, thank God.
Mm, oh
but
yes.
As a child, he created a basketball league for his sons.
Okay.
Everybody benefited, but entire community, the neighborhood. Mm-hmm. But so his sons would have something to be involved with.
To see
that kind of commitment from a parent.
Yes.
That's amazing. So let's talk about her career.
Well, her career is soaring. She's done, it's amazing because we started on MySpace. She was number two on MySpace. I'm talking about took over MySpace at 13 or 14.
Hey, I'm trying to think.
Yes.
MySpace is way back in the day.
She's and I would come home, get off the internet, get off the internet,
wow.
You know. But she was making such an impact with our music on there and in school. But after eighth grade, I homeschooled her.
Really?
Because of all the activities going on, her being a celebrity on MySpace.
Mm-hmm.
The school recommended I keep her home.
Okay.
Because it was so much activity to everybody. You know, it looks bigger to kids when kids are on the internet, you know, getting all that fame.
Right.
But now she's doing great. She went there. She went to Facebook, millions, you know, and just kept going. Internet star.
Right. Social media.
Yes. I had really taken on social media here because I'm such a brainiac, so I got to learn the inner workings of everything.
Right.
So I said one night, I said, you need to get on IG. She said, I'm on IG. I said, that's the next big platform.
Right.
And we need to do this. And we got 9 seconds to really, you know, get people to follow you. Let's do something with the fitness. And I figured it out 2:00 in the morning.
Wow.
Yes, really. I said, come here. We need to do a video right now. And she did it. And it just went. So she's soaring in the millions. Of course, she's done 3 movies.
Right, she's
a
Netflix
actress
as well.
Original. She has.
Is it
EPs.
Currently on Netflix?
Yes, yes. The After Party.
The After Party.
Yes.
Okay.
And she came there as just a small little part when she walked in, and then the director said, "Oh, we need more from her."
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
So we became a principal. It was great. Great experience.
Right.
Here in New York, and then we met 2 independent directors that wanted her. I, you know, did the business first. It took me about 6 months to negotiate. And they became wealthy.
Wow.
Yes. So everything worked out perfectly. Now she's back strong to her music. She was making music all along, but in the pandemic, she buckled down. I'm telling you, the music that's coming for you guys, you heard Shake Something.
Right.
Oh my God, it's so big. It's so big, the music is so big.
I'm excited about
yeah,
that.
Yeah, so, and so are the executives. So we're definitely in meetings and soaring, you know, the new heights and things like that.
So are you looking to get on with a, so is she under a label? Is it your company?
My, yeah, I have Boss Mate Records.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's what's up. Mm-hmm. And now she's touring the country.
Yes.
So you just came from.
Oh my God, where are we? We're in New York now.
Yes.
I know, I'm just like back to back to back to back. We're in Virginia. We were down Atlanta. We do California a lot. We do Atlanta and we do New York.
Mm-hmm.
So we're all, you know, mm-hmm. all of that going mm-hmm. on continuously.
How did you come up with her name?
Well, Lauren Alease is her name. L.A. Lauren Alease.
Oh,
that's her real name.
Like L.L.?
Yes.
Got it, ladies.
Lauren Alease.
Okay, got it.
And then the boss. She was always bossy. She's
okay.
feisty. She's
like
very
her mama.
Feisty.
She's,
yeah, she's very bossy, feisty, you know.
Like
she
mother,
grew up in my slum.
Like mother,
so.
Like
yes,
daughter.
Yes, yes,
okay.
yes.
Okay.
Then she wanted to add love to it because she's such a lovely person. Like, she loves life. I tried to create a life where, when I didn't come from. I mm-hmm. came from the inner city. She never came from that.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So she loves life because she didn't have to go through as much as I had to go through.
Right.
So when you create that for your children, they have different struggles.
Right.
Than what we had growing up in hood.
Right.
Right?
Right.
So she's a lovely person.
Right.
And yeah.
And I've followed her on IG.
Yes.
And she's got a spiritual side
yeah.
as well.
Very spiritual. I always talk about God in the household.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
I say, don't. Ask me, go to God.
Right.
Because you have to have a personal relationship with Him.
Right.
I will sit down and tell you the pros and cons, but at the end of the day, you have to make that decision what's best for you. Mm-hmm. And I support my kids in what they do, but also say, well, if there's a better way to do it, I mm-hmm. suggest it. I never tell them that they don't have real feelings and decisions that they want to do. I'm just going to help you get there smarter.
Right.
That's what I come in.
Right. So where do you see your daughter in 5 years?
Megastar.
Megastar.
Yes. Mega. Global.
Ashanti.
Big.
Alicia Keys. Beyonce.
Yes.
Got it.
That's what they're predicting.
Okay.
You know, they know what they're talking about.
Can I get on just to...
Yeah, she can come in here and say hi.
Just to say hello to this big star.
You can come in.
Just say hi. Just wave to my people.
Hi.
She's like, yeah. Naturally beautiful. Get your natural. Yes.
Right, thank you.
Yes. But we're very supportive. We're one.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
She answers my phone calls and I answer hers. And okay. nobody knows who it is.
Okay. So now you're telling me that you're involved with some service projects.
Yes.
Getting involved with
yes.
some community service or some philanthropy.
Yes.
Tell me about that.
My goal has always been helping young women,
mm-hmm.
you know, because I run into young women, especially in the industry, that never really got guided by a mom or
right.
things of that nature. And I try to be the mom spirit for everyone, you know, mm-hmm. to talk to really be open,
gotcha.
Not telling you can't do it, but how are we going to do it? Let's right. make it a smart decision.
Right.
I want to see every girl in every inner city middle school have mm-hmm. all the hygiene products they need.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, so I'm setting that up now, and Bronx will be my first.
Nice.
Just to be able to know how to do your hair, your makeup, you know, take care of your hygiene and things like that, you'll feel better as a person.
Mm-hmm.
I did self-esteem and etiquette classes in my salon for underprivileged girls, and mm-hmm. it was amazing,
mm-hmm.
okay?
Mm-hmm.
So I want to take it now on a broader scale mm-hmm. for all the schools to have, so the girl can go in, and L.A. is assisting me also, mm-hmm. so she can relate to the young people and really have a blog. They can go to a blog and, you know, learn more and speak with her and things like that.
Got it.
We'll come in and do classes.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
they will all have products for their hair, you know, the menstrual cycle,
mm-hmm.
all of those things that girls mm-hmm. need, you know, and mm-hmm. to understand what it is.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So that's my mission,
mm-hmm.
you know, through God. I say, we're good. I know where my kids are going and everything, but I have still my mission that I have to complete.
Mm-hmm.
Mom.
Mm-hmm. That's amazing. I have a similar passion for black boys, black
okay.
men.
Okay.
Sisters, y'all, you know, we were just talking with the staff earlier. Mm-hmm. Sisters, they're more of you than more of me.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
True,
so
true.
is a blessing to know that you have people that actually care, because that's part of it.
Yes.
You know, we don't have enough people that actually care about doing for others.
Yeah.
And so when you find someone like yourself, not from this community, not from this area,
no,
but care about the people because we're the same wherever we are.
I love people.
Yeah.
And that's, God gave me that gift. I recognized that early on in what I have to complete. I have to be obedient. So, you know, and use the gifts that he gives you in the right way. Mm-hmm. And it's about helping people.
Mm-hmm. What have been some of your challenges in terms of your experience?
Well, first
managing,
of all,
you know,
being a female.
Always that.
That can, it's a man-dominated, you know, area of expertise in the music, in film, but I've earned my stripes and I have my respect, because once you stay true to what you're doing and don't bend for other people, you just have to know your vision.
Right.
And if they're not the right fit, they're not the right fit.
Right.
And you just have to keep going till you get that one. It only takes one.
Right.
You know, so we are very comfortable. The industry knows me. I'm not a mama bear. I'm just smart about what we're doing. You know, because men think sometimes you're, oh, you can't get past the mother. I never run it like that. You can speak to her, talk to her and everything, but I'm not going to let you take advantage. It's a difference.
See, that's key. Yeah, I mean, you're in an industry that is cutthroat.
Well, you heard about the Me Too and all that. It's so true.
Oh.
But, you know, and people don't want to snitch in our community. You're called a snitch. But, no, we have to protect our black women
Absolutely.
As well. And I believe in protection. That's what I do.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And I saw the entourage.
Yeah.
I know you got people that are going to look out and do what has to be done
if
necessary.
We had a stalker come in last night at her event. Oh,
really?
Oh, yeah. We had to deal with that.
Wow.
Yeah, so it's real out here, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And you just got to keep your eyes open and watch your moves and keep good people around you.
Right.
It's very tough.
Right.
Very tough.
So you're in Mount Vernon tonight.
Yes.
You're in New Jersey tomorrow.
Yes.
And Sunday.
Yes, both days. Yes.
And then where are you?
We're heading home to Maryland.
To Maryland.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
My little bungalow.
Okay.
I miss my...
So you have a place in Maryland and Atlanta.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, well, that's what's up. That's what's up. Do you have any movie projects coming?
Oh, yes, we do. Mm-hmm.
Please,
yes, we
please
do.
Share. Please share.
I'm a director and a producer myself, so I'm going to the movie business myself. She has a couple projects on the table I'm reviewing now. It's definitely got to be the right fit.
Right.
Because when you're trying to elevate to a different feel of what you want your career to be, we do this too, but, you know, we still want to. You want to get locked in a box. You want to try some different stuff.
Right.
Yeah. She likes thrillers and comedy and things like that.
Right. Okay. Mm-hmm. It's beautiful to have a talented daughter. My daughter is 15 years old.
Oh.
She's going to be performing for the Edinburgh Arts Festival in Scotland this summer.
Oh, my.
So she's
going with her?
See, who's that's the whole thing. I saw that movie Taken.
Yeah. Who's going
with
her?
I don't play. So my wife will probably go with her for part of it.
Okay.
But I'm going to try to get out there.
Yeah, just because you hear so much of these young girls, they send them to camps or, you know, the sports stuff, and then you find out 20 years later things wasn't what you thought it was. I just really...
I mean, we saw that with a Boy Scout troop.
Yeah.
Like back in like maybe 7, 8 years ago, we had to shut that down.
Yes.
Because we couldn't get insurance.
I knew about that too. But I have a grandson I raised from birth, and he's in the music business, and he is... Oh my goodness. Alease talented, but he's
a singer, dancer.
Okay, he writes his own rapper, singer. He designs clothing.
Is that right?
Yes, he asked for a sewing machine 3 years ago.
Mm.
And I always fed his art, pens and pencils, and he drew all over his walls and all. You know, he loves all the art. But he also is a writer, freestyler, where he doesn't put it on the paper.
Really?
He goes in and feels the vibe, he knows notes, keys, everything.
Wow.
He was raised with L.A., so he just was in there picking up everything.
Right.
But his art talent is amazing. He just has a gift, you know? So I'm putting it all in perspective. He has so much just like her. But the designing, I know he's going to do fabulous with that.
And his name is?
Aeon Terrace. Yeah, he's on my IG. He got a new single coming out and all that.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so why don't you share for the audience,
because
we're about to close, how they can reach and see your daughter
on
social media.
On social media, I'm LA Love the boss manager. So it's L-A-L-O-V-E, the T-H-E, mm-hmm. boss, B-O-S-S, manager. That's mm-hmm. me. And you can find anything through hitting those links of all my artists.
Okay.
Yeah, and she's on my page, he's on my page, and I have two other artists that are not my children.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel like they're my children.
Yeah,
I feel like they're my children because I just nurture them so much.
That's nice.
Yeah,
I love them. Mm-hmm. Do they tour with you guys?
Yeah, one's touring now. The young lady, one of my artists can't do it. She works and do it. You know, you got to get to a level where your music's paying for it and things like that. But my other artist is with us as well. He loves to, you know, he's from this side, New Jersey.
Okay.
So whenever we do, well, he flies out too, though, but he'll be wherever we are.
Okay.
Yeah, he's coming out strong this year.
Nice, nice. So you're doing your thing.
Yes.
Keep it up, sister.
I'm loving it. Thank you so much, and thank you for having me. I'm looking forward to coming back.
Oh, can't wait to have you. Next time we're going to have your daughter.
Oh, yes, for sure, in the program. You know about the girls' program. Definitely.
Yes.
Come back
oh, absolutely
that.
Because mm-hmm. that's connected to what we're
yeah,
doing. If we can help with you,
yeah.
you can get that
I
off
reviewed
the ground.
You guys. Your write-up. This cannot be more perfect.
All right. That's
yes.
what's up.
Thank you for
that's
having me, for
thanks
sure.
Thanks for showing up.
Mm-hmm. You're
all right.
Welcome.
Mm-hmm.
Great.
And we'll be right back.
I already knew that I was gonna go to college, you know, from a young age. I definitely wanna major in political science, become the mayor or something, make the situation better for other people. My name is Justin, and I am your dividend.
Your girls have been with you through every moment of your life. They were with you when you felt unbreakable, and with you when you had your heart broken. They were with you when you shared your love with the world, and with you when she became your world. They're still with you right now. But how well do you know them?
We are back for our second segment featuring the two sisters from the Carriage Suite. And we have Karizma and Robin.
Hi.
Thanks
Hi.
For joining us.
Thank you for having us.
Okay, so we like to just start out by you guys telling us a little bit about your company, Carriage Suite.
Absolutely. Want me to start, sis?
Yes.
Okay, so Carriage Suite, we are so proud of. Carriage Suite is the first Black-owned children's boutique.
That's what's up.
In Harlem, Spanish Harlem. We are on the east side of Harlem, located at 104. Between 3rd and Lexington,
yes.
and we are really proud. This is our second year, and we are dope.
Yes.
We are dope.
Okay. And we specialize in strollers, car seats, high chairs. We customize clothing. We brought back the old school hard bottom yes. walking shoes.
Absolutely.
Oh, get out
yes.
of here.
The hard bottoms, yes. We do photo right? shoots.
Yes.
yes.
Okay. We have a lactation corner.
We have
read to the kids.
Yeah.
Lactation corner.
Yes. Absolutely.
We partner with the city of New York, and we have a lactation corner.
Okay.
So moms can come in and breastfeed.
And breastfeed.
Their babies.
I actually have never heard of that before.
Yes, that's like, what lactation is.
Okay.
Yes. The babies latch on.
Where else do they have those?
Well, they have them. They spread it around
yeah,
the city.
The city.
So
most of the city locations mm-hmm. will have them. So moms can privately go. And feed their children. So
really?
We partnered up.
Yes.
yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So something good.
Why did you decide on carriages? How did that concept come about?
Carriages came because of the lack of need of it in our community.
Mm-hmm.
And so with raising our children many moons ago.
Mm-hmm.
Over 10 years ago, right?
Okay,
we'll go with that. Over 10 years ago, we decided, raising our boys, we had really, you know, nothing in our community.
Yeah.
So we wanted nice things. We wanted to look good. We wanted all of that quality stuff and just couldn't find it in our neighborhood,
right.
which forced us to go,
out
our neighborhood, past 96th Street, to another borough, Jersey, Yonkers, something.
Mm-hmm.
But it was nothing in Harlem where we could go. Mm-hmm. To get strollers or to get real good quality children's apparel. So mm-hmm. we decided about 10 years ago to start saving, yeah. mm-hmm. and that we were going
it
to open up.
I think it was about 15 years ago.
Saving, right? Yeah. Yes, a lot of money. But mm-hmm. we decided that we were going to just stop talking about it and do it.
That's mm-hmm. what's up.
And it's a need. It's yeah. babies are born every second. So mm-hmm. The demand for it is unspeakable. Yeah. You have to have strollers.
Yeah. No, so it basically started out as a conversation. Mm-hmm. We would say
between you two.
Between us two.
Yeah. Okay. And my older sister.
How long have
too.
You known each other? How long have you known
oh.
each other?
Oh God. All right, so here we go with this. So long time ago,
right.
at my father's church, mm-hmm. we sung in the choir
He's
together.
He's a pastor, your dad?
He was, yeah, he was. He passed. So,
we were talking about 5, 6 years old. I was on the choir.
Oh, yeah, we
talking about, yeah. This is lifelong
friends. Right, lifelong friends.
Yeah. Wow. Yes. Okay. So we sung in the choir, and...
y'all got voice? Y'all can sing?
I don't think so.
Don't do that. No, we're not going to go with that. That's the next segment. That's segment three. So when you have the R&B singers, we'll
right,
come back
we'll
for that.
Right, we'll come back
for
that.
So, we'll have you back. Yeah, we'll have you back. But so then we distance ourselves.
Of course.
Yeah, you know,
she was
life.
On the east side, I was on the west side. Life, yeah,
life
college,
happens.
Kids.
And then
and
we
about
met
15
again.
Years ago, we met at a friend of ours had a like fitness
that.
Class.
That
you
didn't
know,
work,
but
obviously.
I guess it didn't work out for us. But we had
you can tell, right?
But we had a, it was a fitness class, and we seen each other there, and we was like,
like, you know how you,
you
know
somebody? You know somebody, and right. we just
and we
couldn't
just
pinpoint
could
it.
Pick right. it up. But from that day, though,
uh-huh. we was like inseparable.
Yeah, we've been together
that's
ever.
Right.
That's
so,
beautiful.
And then we kind of put the pieces
story.
Together,
yeah.
and now
and a friend,
it's
the woman
beyond.
Who used to take us to, her, who used to take me to her father's church, passed away.
Okay.
And we didn't even tell each other, but we wound up at the funeral. And
wow.
she was like, "How you know Miss Alice?" And I was like, "How you know Miss Alice?" And she came to find out that I'm like, "That's who used to bring me to church."
Wow.
And she like. No, and her mother like we got pictures and
yeah,
so we realized
it
wrong.
Was meant to be together.
Right, exactly.
Right.
And then it just goes on and on and on. We have
right.
families
family
on both
and
sides
friends
that are connected
that know each
on
other
different. It's just weird.
Yeah,
it's just
so.
Meant to be actually.
So and you're both in law enforcement, right?
That is correct.
In what sense?
Yes, yeah, so I'm a police officer in NYPD.
Oh, I feel safer.
And yes. I'm a chaplain for the Department of Corrections for the state.
Really?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah,
that's
so
wonderful.
We're going on sometimes. I have 18 years in.
You're Muslim.
Yes, I'm Muslim.
And I'm Christian.
Christian,
yeah,
okay. So you got the best of two worlds.
There yes. you go. You got to be blessed
That's
somehow,
excellent.
Right?
That's yes. excellent. What are some of the challenges you guys have found, you know, doing what you do with your business?
Well, the number one challenge is that we don't really have anybody in our business that looks like us, right?
Right?
So breaking that wall down is challenging every day.
It's just a
because
barrier.
You're breaking
yes.
down... people's opinions. You're constantly always fighting for what you believe in, what we need. And so that is an everyday challenge, mm-hmm. just people just believing in us and understanding that we're serious.
Right.
And what
is,
we're doing is mm-hmm. really good. And,
right.
And it's
the quality is good right. and it's needed and it's not fake. It's really, you know, when you come to the store, you got to come to the store. The
yeah,
store is amazing,
yeah,
but we've put our sweat and tears into the store and it looks amazing.
Okay.
But it's also because we know our people deserve it,
right?
Right? They deserve to be able to walk on marble floors. And the customer service, as soon as you walk
okay.
in the door, you're greeted. Like, mm-hmm. all of that is not something that we take for granted.
No.
Right.
We really believe our people deserve this, and that's what we're trying to do.
Right.
We're
the
trying
energy.
To.
Yeah,
the energy is amazing.
Feel
it just feels
in.
Like home. It's mm-hmm. just the cutest thing.
Right.
And but not only that, we are really giving good things.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You know?
And we're making it like a safe haven for the community
Absolutely.
As well. So, you know, growing up, we had mom and pop shops that we can go into
right.
and just be who we needed to be.
Right.
You know, if our parents didn't have money, we was able to go into the corner store and say, we need a carton of milk or something like that. So we're making it like a safe haven also
Absolutely.
Where the neighborhood children can come in and just get some air, get some water, get some candy, get whatever we have. So we keep stuff in the store just for the community.
That's
like, you know, even on Fridays, we feed the community.
Absolutely. I want you to talk
so,
I want you to talk a lot about that
yes.
because
so
I was so
this
impressed.
Is,
this
as is Friday.
This is going on.
So, as
yes.
is
so you
going
guys
on,
are here instead
yes.
of...
We're here, but we physically have family members out
mm-hmm.
in front of our store giving out
food
and lunch to the community. And so we've been doing this for maybe about 2 months
give
now.
Give back, right, give
yeah,
back.
Exactly, just
and that's
that.
What it's about.
And that's just one thing we do. This
right.
is our new project, but we've been giving back since we opened
our
door.
Since we opened
door.
Up our doors,
And so
yes.
we are really, really, really serious about that. And so every year coming up August 26th, mm-hmm. we have our second block party.
It's our second year anniversary. So every year on every anniversary, we give a community give back. It's a community appreciation day. So Saturday, nice. August 26th, we have a community appreciation day, nice. Which everything is free. The block is blocked off on the Hunt Fourth between 3rd and Lexington.
That's where the shop is.
Right. Yes. Mm-hmm. So everything on that block everything is free.
Let's get that address. What's the address?
172 East 104th between 3rd and Lexington on the east side of Harlem.
Okay, that's Spanish Harlem.
Spanish Harlem.
Okay, yes. Okay. Mm-hmm. And you guys are Harlem girls, right?
Yes, we are. Mm-hmm. But we're born and raised in high school? Harlem. I went to Louis D. Brandeis.
And I went to Central Park East.
Okay.
And
you both went to college?
Yes.
I went to college, but I didn't finish.
That's
until
fun.
Later on. I actually graduated from McAllister with my funeral services license.
Oh, so, get out.
Yeah, well, we're doing a lot of things.
You got some mortician skills?
Yes, mortician skills. I'm actually a board exam away from being a licensed funeral director for the state of New York.
We're
trying to take this serious.
So you got both. The beginning and
the end. Hello. Like, we're going to bring them in the world and we're going to take them out.
Whoa. So somewhere you got to come to us, right?
You got to come to us somewhere.
And I went to College in Talladega, Alabama.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's HBCU.
Okay, that's what's up. So what do you see the company in 5 years?
Oh, my God. So we get this question, and it's really hard to answer because I feel like every day our vision is growing. And I feel like if we say what it's going to do in 5 years, we are closing and we're boxing it in.
Okay.
So it's really hard to say in 5 years where it's going to be because it just keeps growing. It gets bigger and bigger by the day. And so if we had to say what it would be in 5 years,
just expand it to the moon. Many levels.
Like, we want another location probably by 5 years.
Yeah. We already started a nonprofit, another umbrella of the company, which is for the community. So
doing the things that you've been doing.
Doing the things that we're doing and just putting it on a different level and a platform.
Mm-hmm.
But in 5 years, I think we will be
well established,
but just
throughout the world.
The masses. So if we're giving out 100 meals today, in 5 years,
we want to be giving
5 million. Like, you know what I mean? We just want to we just want to keep going until we can't go anymore.
That's what's up. Can you tell us about where do you get your product from?
So right now we only have 4 manufacturers that we're working with. Uh-huh. We're working with Thule, we're working with Mima, Duna, and Cybex.
Yes.
How'd you select these 4 companies?
Oh,
well, they didn't select us, we selected them, I guess, in a sense.
Yeah, in a sense.
Like she spoke about in the beginning of the segment, it was hard for us to knock down the barriers. So one of the companies that we got a hold to, it was so hard to communicate with them. They was wondering how we got their numbers, their information. So one company gave us 10 minutes. He said, we're sending a representative out to you for 10 minutes, and you have 10 minutes, and that's it. This gentleman stayed with us for 4 hours.
Wow.
Right.
So that was Cybex.
So you guys are impressive like that.
Right. So that just goes to show people believe in us.
That's
and so
up.
From that, from
then
him saying
up,
yes to us, it opened up
kind of
3 more doors, really, that they believed in us. So that's the thing. If you believe in us, we got you. We're going to soar, and we're going to do what we got to do. So
I am so glad I was able to have you for the show.
Thank you for showing up.
You guys are amazing.
Thank you. Appreciate you.
All right. Thank you for joining us for this episode of Ignite, Empower, Transform. I was your host, Hosea James Givan II. And remember, if it's in your heart, do your part. Today's help equals tomorrow's hope. I love our youth. Power to the people.
Power to the people.